So now look at example of the vertical scalability. Okay, so we have the computers now. So we have computers connected in a network, and each computer is having the configuration like this. Okay, so these are the computers connected in network. Okay, so like this here. Now here. Okay. So this computer is also connected to the, and this computer is having the same configuration, that is a 3 gigs, 2 GB RAM and HDD same. Okay, so here, so like this. So this is called as a vertical scalability. Why? Because if we need one of the machine, then we can increase it vertically. Okay, so not horizontally means we are not increasing the configuration of any one of the machine. We are going to add extra machine. Okay, so here, so this machine also 3 gigs and 2 GB RAM and 1 TB of hard disk. 3 gigs, 2 GB RAM and 1 TB of hard disk, and 3 gigs, 2 GB RAM and 1 TB of hard disk. Okay, so like here, so on. Now here, so like this here. Okay. So on. So here, what is happening? So parallelly, these machines will work parallelly. Okay. So parallelly, these machines will work. Okay. So each machine is having its own CPU for the processing. Yes or no? Okay, Vikram. So suppose there are 1,000 computers in this network. How many computers? 1,000 computers in this network. Okay, they are in network, and parallelly they can run a particular job. They can run particular task. Okay, so means task is run by this computer, task is run by this computer, task is run by this computer, task is run by the same task is run by the okay all computers. Same task is run by the all computers. Okay, so they definitely here the advantage is a cost effective, okay, low failure rate, yes or no, and high speed of processing. Vikram, don't be mute yourself. So these are the advantages. Okay, so first advantage is nothing but here cost effective. Second advantage is nothing but a low failure rate, and third advantage is nothing but a high speed of processing. Get this, Vikram?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So see here, all these computers are connected in a network here. These computers are connected in network, and they are executing the job parallelly. They are executing job parallelly. Okay. So what are the advantages here? So advantage is nothing but the first one is a cost effective, second is a low failure rate, and third is a high speed of processing. So if this computer become fail, if which computer, so suppose second number computer become fail, then we can replace that computer only. So means remaining computers will still working. Okay, so that is why here we can say low failure rate. So it's not happening, means actually there is no any single point failure available in this type of scalability. Okay, so high speed of the performance, that is near about the 100 times faster than your older system, that is a vertical scalability. Okay, so this is an example of your horizontal scalability. Getting this concept, Vikram?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, so what did you think about it? Okay, so now tell me, so what do you think about this? What effect do you get here now?
सर म्हणजे वन वन नॉट म्हणजे वन एखादा कॉम्प्युटर जर फेल्युअर झाला तर म्हणजे बाकीच्या सिस्टीमवर काय फरक पडत नाही.
ओके ओके, टेल मी, जस्ट ट्राय टू एक्सप्लेन इन इंग्लिश.
ओके सर. व्हेन वन कॉम्प्युटर गेट फेल्युअर देन देयर इज नो इफेक्ट ऑन अनदर सिस्टम्स.
Okay, okay. And actually, these are the, again, one of the benefit is that here, these computers are not so much costly. Okay, these are not so much costly. So as we compare, okay, so compare with our server, okay, these computers are not so much costly.
So what is the reason?
So reason is that here, these are the means these are commodity hardware. Now there is a concept of the commodity hardware. Commodity hardware.
Sir, commodity means?
Commodity hardware. So means cheap hardware. What? Cheap hardware. Yes. So cheap hardware means our computers now, whatever our computer and laptop we are using. Okay. So these are the cheap hardware, sir. Vikram. Yes, sir. I have a laptop and of rupees 45,000 and you are saying this is a cheap hardware. Yes, this is cheap hardware. See, laptop with high performance laptop. Okay. So why? See here, high performance laptop. One TB with 1 TB hard disk. Okay, high performance machine with 1 TB of hard disk. Okay, so that takes around 50 lakh rupees. So this is the main difference. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Getting this concept?
Yes, sir.
So in short, here it is not, but I am trying to explain you. Okay. So this is like that. Okay. So miss, if you're going to purchase the high performance and original hardware. Okay. So then these hardwares are very, very, very costly. Very, very costly. Okay. So all these are the cheap. See here, this machine. Okay. So might be we can purchase this machine in at around 25,000 rupees. This machine in 25,000 rupees. This machine in 25,000. This machine in 25,000. Okay. So like this parallel. Okay. All these machines. So because this is a commodity hardware, and if one of the machine become failure, then we can replace the data. We can replace that machine. Yes. So this is one of the advantage. Okay. Now, the second advantage that in vertical scalability, okay, is that over the vertical scalability is that here we can process our task. We can divide our task in multiple machine. Okay. See, now suppose here I have 10 sticks. I have 10 sticks. And I say, Vikram, please break this 10 sticks. Okay. Each stick requires 2 minutes for the breaking it up. Each stick requires how many minutes? 2 minutes. Okay, Vikram.
Yes, sir.
So total time will require 20 minutes.
1, 2, 3, 4. Sir.
20 minutes. Okay, so if I would like to reduce this time, okay, so I can say just divide this work in 10 peoples, okay, and just give one stick to one person. Now tell me how much time it will take to break all 10 sticks.
Sir, 10% less time. It requires less time.
Less time in this is what? Only 2 minutes. Only 2 minutes. Because each person can break a stick in 2 minutes. So parallelly, all these persons are breaking stick. Parallelly, all these persons are breaking stick. So means definitely all these 10 sticks will break up. Okay, in only
2 minutes.
2 minutes. This is the main difference. Okay. So here actually there was a single processor. There was a single processor. Okay, actually that was a very higher level configuration machine, but after all that is nothing but a single machine. Okay. So that single machine can process okay with high speed, but there is a limitation for that, okay, processing. That is why here we are going to divide that process in multiple systems. Okay. And that is nothing but a horizontal scalability. Clear this concept?
Okay, Vikram? Sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So any doubt about this now?
No, sir.
No? Clear this concept. So that is why we need Hadoop. So Hadoop works like this. It works like this. Okay. Clear this idea of Vikram?
Sir, actually Hadoop manjas hai ka? That is horizontal scalability.
This is Hadoop uses horizontal scalability. use this horizontal scalability to run tasks parallelly. So means a task is going to be executed on thousands of computer cluster.
Means it works on the basis of this.
Yes. The concept, core concept is this here. Actually, what means a vertical scalability? What means horizontal scalability? What are the benefits of the vertical scalability or horizontal scalability? And what are the benefits of the horizontal scalability or the vertical scalability with advantage and disadvantages? We have to discuss this. We have to have know about all these concepts. Clear this?
Yes, sir.
Okay, getting this concept. Any doubt regarding this?
No, sir.
No, sure?
No.
Who is sitting with you?
सर फ्रेंडच्या घरी
आहे. तुमच्या फ्रेंडच्या घरी आहे का? ओके. सो नाऊ कॅन आय कंटिन्यू फॉर द नेक्स्ट कन्सेप्ट?
येस सर.
ओके, सो हू इज दिस फ्रेंड?
सर आहे एकटा आहे, म्हणजे घराला.
क्लासमेट?
नाही सर, घराजवळच आहे.
ओके ओके. नाऊ सो okay, so here that is nothing but a so high speed that is of 100 times faster than older one. That is a cost effective. Third is nothing but a low failure rate, and next is nothing but so easy for maintenance. So execution, parallel execution is the one of the advantage. Parallel processing, we can say. This is the advantage of the horizontal scalability over the vertical scalability. Okay, so cost effective means uses commodity hardware. Commodity hardware in this is what we can say. Marathi madhe apan tyala swast machine mhanuya, swast computer. Okay. So the computer in the means it's not like in 10,000 rupees. Okay, little bit good means whatever we are using right now, these are the commodity hardwares. Okay,
actually, so, sir, what is the difference?
Actually, there is a technical difference in the so we can say, we can go for the Google now. Just you can Google it. Okay, so difference between so commodity hardware and high performance hardware. So definition, what is the commodity hardware? The definition is by Wikipedia. Commodity hardware in an IT context, okay, is a device, okay, a component that is relatively inexpensive, widely available for the more or less interchangeable with other hardware of its type. Okay, to be interchangeable, commodity hardware is usually broadly compatible and can function on a plug and play basis on the commodity product. Okay, manje swasta computer. Okay, so here I can say I'm going to Google and the cost of 1 TB hard disk. Cost of 1 TB hard disk. Okay. So we are going to search it from the manufacturer side. That is a Seagate. Seagate India. You can Vikram, you can Google it, okay, yourself from your side.
Okay, sir.
So difference between rate and their functionality, etc., etc.
Okay, sir.
So proper tumhala jar ekadi website vagere bhetli tar tyachi tumhala sagli mahiti bhetun jail.
Okay, okay.
So now let popularity sort by high to low. So this is a 500 GB hard disk, Sony HD. Okay, so 2.5 external hard disk, 500 GB at rupees 16,099. So 4 TB wide. Okay, you can search for that. Okay, so commodity hardware and high performance hardware.
Sir,
so
what is the difference between wired and permanent?
Which one? Wired means what? You can external hard disk, we can attach it from the USB. So we can attach it from the USB. Okay, just apun pen drive lavton tasa hard disk aste, like a pen drive. Okay, so high performance. Okay. Lenovo ThinkCentre. Lenovo ThinkCentre. See here. What is the price? Vikram.
Sir. Hello, sir.
What is the price?
Sir, 73,142.
Okay. So this is the price for this system. So what is the configuration we can see here?
Intel Core i3.
So 4 GB RAM. So what is hard disk size? 1 TB. Okay. So 128 GB solid state drive. Actually, this is another one of the configuration available. Okay. So in market.
So
this is the fastest drive. Yes. So performance वाढवण्यासाठी ज्या गोष्टी परफॉर्मन्स कमी करतात ओके त्यांचा परफॉर्मन्स वाढवण्यासाठी ह्या सगळ्या गोष्टीचा वापर केला जातो ठीक आहे. सो रॅम 4 GB. सो आय से रिलेव्हंट नॉट हाय टू लो 4 GB ऑफ रॅम. सी हियर HDMI VGA. Okay. So 4 GB of RAM. I say RAM 4G. I'm going to search for the RAM 4G. 4 GB of RAM. In DDR3. Okay. Here, high to low.
ते लॅपटॉप
चालेल. लॅपटॉप आहे सी रॅम
77,000.
येस क्लिअर दिस. ओके ठीक आहे. दिस इज व्हेरी मच सफिशियंट फॉर यू विक्रम.
ओके
सो दॅट मीन्स व्हॉट हिअर नाव. सो व्हॉट एव्हर वी आर युझिंग कम्प्युटर्स नाव दीज आर द कम्प्युटर्स दीज आर कम्प्युटेड हार्डवेअर्स. ओके not yes, what you can say high performance machines. High performance machines are very costly and they are producing high performance. They can use 24 hours of a day, okay, continuously. They are built up, okay, so in that way, in that technique, okay, they must be provide high performance. Okay, so manje shakyato 99% failure chances nahi, fakt 1% failure chances hai, kithi only 1% means in all cases they are going to test it in higher, in high voltage, in low voltage, and means warmer power down, warmer power up. Okay, so fluctuations etc ha saglya goshti mai karna check up kelela asto and the hardware swata evada compatible asto ha saglya goshti te maintain kelela asto mule. Okay, and so this is okay clarification from my side Vikram. Actually concepts are different. Okay, कन्सेप्ट थोडेसे वेगळे राहू शकतात परंतु क्लॅरिफिकेशन हे सगळं माझ्याकडून आहे विक्रम. क्लिअर?
यस सर. यस सर.
ओके सो नाऊ इंट्रोडक्शन टू द हडूप. इंट्रोडक्शन टू हडूप. ओके एक्चुअली व्हॉट हॅज हॅपन. सो गुगल सो so what are the starting year. Okay, so start year, so exactly I am not sure about the starting year of the Google. Okay, so but suppose 1990. Okay, we can Google it now. So starting year of the Google, when Google was started. So starting year of Google. So 1997 domain google.com was registered on the September 15, 1997. Okay, they formally incorporated their company Google on 4th September 1998. Okay, so yes 1998. From the 1998 up to the 2003, Google have faced okay challenges about the storing data. Challenges about the about storing data means that time your hard disk were means hard disk size maximum 20 GB hoti that was. Okay, 10 GB 20 GB asha size madhe hard disk available hotya. So tani so many challenges tani face kele. They invented so many applications and what we can say framework. Okay, so for working in their okay field. So about processing data. About processing data and storing data. But what happened here? But data is going increasing. So that time Google has produced okay. So in 2003, okay. So Google gives one of the concept here, one of the new invention, and that was that that label was Google File System. Google File System, and in 2004 they have given, okay, so for the processing, that is a map reduce. That process, okay, but problem is what here? Both are on paper, white paper. The problem was what? So the problem was both are on paper. Both was on white paper. So what do you mean about the white paper? Yes, Vikram.
Hello, sir.
Now, what do you mean about white paper?
No, sir.
Yes. Any concept? Any idea about the white paper?
No, sir.
No. Okay. So actually, this concept. Okay. So this concept on only paper. Only paper. So what we can say, that is a paper presentation. We can say what? Publishing paper. Okay. Publishing paper means one concept has introduced by Google. Okay. So, and they have only published on it paper. Yes. Means actually implementation was not there. Okay. So that means not implemented. ओके त्यांनी इम्प्लिमेंट केलं का हे नाही केलं इन्व्हेंट कधी केलं त्यांनी हा कन्सेप्ट एक म्हणजे अशा प्रकारे फाईल सिस्टम राहू शकतो आणि त्यांनी त्या फाईल सिस्टमला काय नाव दिलं GFS दॅट इज अ गुगल फाईल सिस्टम आणि त्या फाईल सिस्टम मध्ये जो स्टोअर केलेला जो डेटा आहे ना तर तो डेटा प्रोसेस करण्यासाठी ओके त्या फाईल सिस्टम मध्ये जो डेटा आहे तो डेटा प्रोसेस करण्यासाठी त्यांनी मॅप रिड्यूस हा कन्सेप्ट इंट्रोड्यूस केला त्यांनी काय कोणता कन्सेप्ट इंट्रोड्यूस केला मॅप रिड्यूस ओके सो ओके विक्रम
यस सर
डिड यू गेट इट
यस सर
डोंट बी टॉक ओके डोंट बी म्हणजे कम्युनिकेट ट्राय टू अटेंड युअर क्लास ओके फ्रॉम युअर होम ओनली ओके अँड प्लीज बी सिन्सिअर अबाउट द क्लास बिकॉज आय एम व्हेरी मच सिरियस अबाउट दिस क्लास
ओके सर ओके
विथ यू ऑल्सो
ऑल्सो
सो हियर 2003-2004 मध्ये गुगल फाईल सिस्टम आणि मॅप रिड्यूस मीन्स व्हॉट प्रोसेसिंग अँड गुगल फाईल सिस्टम इज व्हॉट हिअर स्टोरेज गुगल फाईल सिस्टम इज व्हॉट स्टोरेज ओके सो लेटर ऑन याहू Yahoo. Okay, so Yahoo is nothing but it is one of the largest search engine in the world after Google. Okay, so Google is nothing but what? Google is nothing but a, so largest search engine in the world. Okay. Has faced so many problems while storing data. Okay. So in what year? 1998 to the 2003. Okay. So see now here. Here, whatever I am going to search now, see here. Vikram, what I say now, I say hard disk. Hard disk and I am going to press enter. Vikram. So here it is producing the results here, Vikram. How many records they have searched? How many records they have searched? 25 crore 70 lakh records are searched in what time?
0.81 seconds.
Yes. So because of that, they are using larger data center. They are using, okay, so thousands of nodes in their cluster, and they are using, okay, so Hadoop, they are using the HDFS right now, okay, for the storing file, and they are using the MapReduce for the processing. Yes, this is not possible for a single computer. Okay, so thousands of computers are working parallelly. When you say jeva tumhi mantay ke hard disk and enter, your request is going to be transferred to the Google server, and not a single computer, thousands of computers have start their work for the searching data in the internet, and they are dumping data from the internet, and they are searching for the hard disk. So how many records, and they are parallelly collectively they are returning result to you. Okay, so 25 crore 70,000 records are going to be returned to you in only 0.81 second. This is a great concept. Okay, not only that, here it returns what? Here it returns the file name. Actually, this is the name of the file. Okay, and also it returns what? Here it returns the snippet. What means are part of the portion of that data. Okay, so that contains the word hard disk. Yes, so this is a hard disk here. This is a hard disk. This is a hard. Okay, so yes or no? So like this here. So how many pages are there now? You can see. So 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So like, okay, getting this concept?
Yes, sir.
Getting this concept here, Vikram?
Yes, sir.
So it needs very high speed processor. It needs one of the challenging network and challenging framework. Okay, and that already assured by the Google. Clear this concept?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so what was happened now? See, so Google has introduced GPS in 2003 and 2004 MapReduce on only paper. Actually, GPS means what here? How can we store the data and distributed network and about their concept and exactly? Okay, so different type of the concepts. And MapReduce means here how we can process that data and what type of the programming we can do on that data, etc. Okay, so Yahoo, it is one of the largest search engine in the world after Google. Okay, so Yahoo has in the 2006 and 2007, in the year 2006 to 2007, Yahoo introduces the concept that is a practical implementation concept of the GPS and titled as a HDFS. What is it? HDFS. So it stands for the Hadoop Distributed File System. Okay. And in the year 2007 to 2008, they have introduced that is a processing framework, that is a MapReduce. Okay, so now tell me who is invented the Yahoo. Hadoop concept?
Yahoo.
Actually, Yahoo was not actually Yahoo is inspired by Google. Okay, Yahoo inspired by Google. Okay, inspired by Google. And implementing and start implementing. So started implementation of Hadoop. Okay, so Hadoop is nothing but Hadoop is having only two parts. One is HDFS and second is a MapReduce. Hadoop is having only two parts. That is, one is a HDFS and second is a MapReduce. Okay.
And actually, what is a MapReduce?
MapReduce is a processing tool, processing engine. Okay. So how your data will be processed and exactly what ओके वी विल क्लिअर ऑल दिस कन्सेप्ट इन फ्युचर. सो ऍक्च्युअली मी तुम्हाला काय सांगितलं, यू नीड 4 to 5 लेक्चर्स टू अंडरस्टँड द कन्सेप्ट ऑफ द हाडूप. सो आपण आता सुरुवात तरी केलेली आहे थोडं थोडं करून की माझा नीड काय आहे, माझी गरज काय आहे विक्रम. आपण इथं हाडूप कडे कसं काय टर्न केलो,
बिग डेटा स्टोरेज.
येस येस बिग डेटा. वी हॅव टू मॅनेज आवर डेटा, वी हॅव टू स्टोअर आवर डेटा, अँड नॉट ओनली स्टोअर, वी हॅव टू प्रोसेस आवर डेटा. वी हॅव टू प्रोसेस आवर डेटा. आपण फक्त स्टोअर नाही करणार, आपल्याला आपण त्या डेटाला काय करणार आहोत, प्रोसेस करणार आहोत, त्याला चेक करणार, त्याला सर्च करणार, त्याच्यात हे करणार, ते करणार, अनालिटिक्स प्रोड्यूस करणार. मी तुम्हाला भरपूर काही एक्झाम्पल्स घेतलेले आहेत अनालिटिक्स म्हणजे काय. म्हणजे लास्ट आता म्हणजे माझी कंपनी आहे पाठीमा, माझ्या कंपनीमध्ये सोबत काय म्हणतात त्याला वेगवेगळे स्टेशनरी प्रोडक्ट बनवले जातात आणि मी इथे पाहतोय की बाबा कोणत्या प्रोडक्टला जास्तीत जास्त सेल, कोणत्या प्रोडक्ट जास्तीत जास्त सेल झालेला आहे, कोणत्या महिन्यात कोणत्या आठवड्यात जास्तीत जास्त सेल झाला, त्याचं कारण काय. मी ह्या सगळ्या अनालिसिस जर मला भेटल्या तर मी माझ्या बिझनेसला अजून जास्त प्रमाणात इम्प्रूव्ह करू शकतो. येस. सो मी तुम्हाला काय सांगितलं, मी तुम्हाला सांगितलं आरडीबीएमएस त्याच्या जागे आहे. ओके त्याच्या जागे आहे. आरडीबीएमएस इज परफॉर्मिंग व्हेरी वेल रोल, दे आर आरडीबीएमएस इज कॅटरिंग देअर रोल ओके इन देअर सेक्टर व्हेरी वेल. अँड हडूप इज अ डिफरंट कन्सेप्ट अँड हडूप इज कॅटरिंग देअर रोल इन देअर डिफरंट सेक्टर. ओके सो व्हॉट इज दॅट इयर वी आर वी विल डिस्कस वन बाय वन वन बाय वन. सो ऍक्च्युली द फाउंडर ऑफ हडूप सी वी कॅन सी नाव हिअर. So, founder of Hadoop. See, founder of Hadoop. See, Hadoop was created by the duck cutting and Mike, okay, Caffarella in 2005. Okay, and it was originally developed to support discussions for the Nudge search engine project. Nudge search engine project. ओके सो ऍक्च्युली हडूप हे कोणी इंट्रोड्यूस केलेलं आहे, डक कटिंग.
डक कटिंग,
डक कटिंग. ओके सो DOUG. ओके सो एच कटिंग, डक कटिंग इज द फाउंडर ऑफ हडूप. ओके सो ऍक्च्युली so Yahoo hired duck cutting for the development point of view and duck cutting has started their work on the started the project and actually duck cutting ni hecha agodar jo project start kela hota tya project mein tyana tevda success bhetla nahi nantar tyani nantar Yahoo ya company ne duck cutting la hire kela ani hire kela nantar duck cutting tyani project start kela ani tyani to project successfully develop kela ani tya project la title kay dile gela Hadoop. Okay so what is the logo of the Hadoop? Yes, now tell me. So about the logo of Hadoop, yes Vikram.
Yes sir.
About logo of Hadoop, tell me what is the logo of Hadoop. It is
nahi bagitla sir.
Nahi bagitla
nahi.
ओके तुम्ही काय सर्च केलं विक्रम, तुम्ही
युट्यूबवर बघत होतो.
युट्यूबवर बघत होतो, ठीक आहे. सी व्हॉट इज लोगो ऑफ हडूप, हडूपचा लोगो काय आहे.
Elephant.
Okay. So elephant. Yes. So what is the idea behind that? What was the truth concept big, behind sir. That here? So elephant. Elephant.
Big.
Yes, 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 yes. Elephant means what?
Big.
Big. But actually it's not true. It's not true. Okay. So elephant. Definitely elephant is a, it is a big element. Okay, definitely I accept that here. So it is big animal. Okay, and that is matching with the concept of the big data. They actually data is in big and here that is why they have chosen the animal. Okay, big animal that is an elephant. Okay, for as a logo for this Hadoop concept. But actually, it's not true. So truth behind that, it has very silly background. Okay. So it is the name of toy of duck cutting son. Okay. सो त्याच्या मुलाचं जे खेळणं होतं एलिफंट. सो इट वॉज एलिफंट टॉय. अँड त्या एलिफंट टॉयला त्याचा मुलगा त्याला काय म्हणत होता? हडूप. ओके. सो त्या एलिफंट टॉयचं नाव काय होतं? हडूप. आणि हे कोणी नाव दिलं होतं? त्याच्या मुलाने दिलं होतं. येस येस, त्या लहान मुलाने दिलं होतं. ओके. त्यामुळे डक कटिंगने त्या एलिफंटचं जे टॉय आहे त्याचं नाव त्यांनी ह्या कन्सेप्टला, ह्या प्रोजेक्टला त्यांनी अप्लाय केलं. ओके. सो दिस इज द कन्सेप्ट ऑफ द हडूप. ओके. सो आय थिंक सो विक्रम, सो टुडे आय हॅव टू स्टॉप हिअर नाऊ. सो आय विल शेअर व्हिडिओ अँड आय विल शेअर दिस डॉक्युमेंट विथ यू. ओके. बट विक्रम, प्लीज बी सिन्सिअर अबाउट द क्लास अँड जस्ट कन्सेप्ट क्लिअर कन्सिडर इट इज. ओके. सो it will be the life turning point misconcept for you. So that is why, okay, I attend it sincerely from your home and don't be discussed while class is going run. Okay.
Okay.
So if your friends say, if you want to show your friends and etc just tell say them, just please sit beside. Okay, but don't talk. Please concentrate here. So because I am very much serious about this course.
Okay sir.
Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So have a good day.
Okay, sir. Bye. One day. So, you guys are sending 87. I'm going to have a good day. You're not going to have a good day.